While women make up more than half of the population, we still lag far behind our male counterparts when it comes to salary. According to the Institute for Women's Policy Research, the Missouri women, we actually earn 79 cents on the dollar compared to men. Now, if current trends continue, the gap will not close for another 50 years. And joining us is the best-selling author of It's Your Biz, Susan Solovic.
Solovic,
who will be the keynote speaker at the Stronger Women for a Better Community event this Thursday. So tell me about this event. I know, you know, we're always trying to battle to get that equal pay.
Right.
So what can people expect from this event?
Well, so it's sponsored by the Women's Foundation of St. Louis, and their goal is to actually raise awareness and raise money for organizations that support women's causes. Mm-hmm. This year, we're really focusing on economic independence, and particularly women who may not have the mentors, the role models, the educational resources, et cetera, to really gain that economic independence. So that's what I'm there to talk about, is how women can really step up to the plate. I mean, certainly the disparity is there, and that's probably not going to go away overnight, but there are things that we as women can do to help move that evolution along.
And also connecting and helping each other to try to figure out how to go through that process, because some people are really new to it and managing money and trying to get that, you know, those investments right and get that, you know, get
that
trend.
You know, I find it interesting because a lot of women just, they don't want to know about their money. It's sort of like they let everybody else worry about it. And one of the things I discovered in a lot of the research that I have done is our society still tells women it's not really feminine to talk about money, to want to make a lot of money. But yet, if you don't have the economic independence to take care of yourself and your family, you can really see some disastrous effects. So there's an old Chinese proverb says that women hold up half the sky, and I always say it'd be a lot easier to do that if we own the ground we're standing on.
Wow. So what do you think are going to be some of the biggest lessons that people can take away from the event?
So I'm hoping that women will actually listen to the fact that, you know, I realize there's special nuances that impact a woman's life, caring for children, elderly parents. I'm at that stage in my life right now. So there are things like that that impact our work lives. It doesn't mean that you have to go out and build the Taj Mahal for yourself and your family, but that economic independence gives you the opportunity to make choices. And I will share with you that I practiced divorce law for a period of time, and tragically, I saw a lot of women who would come in, they hadn't worked outside the home, they had small children, the husband takes off, you know, hopefully he's a stand-up guy and plays child support or alimony, but oftentimes they slipped into poverty or had to go home and live with family members, etc. So you really owe it to yourself, your family, to take care of those economic independence items.
Not only when it comes to pay, but also just in managing the money and things like that at home, because like you were saying, there's some people who just they handle the things in the house and that's it, but you need to know what's going on with your money. So
exactly, absolutely.
Okay. So the when and where of the event.
So it is Wednesday night, 5:30 to 8:30 at the Frontenac Hilton. There are tickets still available, so you can call the Women's Foundation, which is 314-780-9356.
Okay, and the tickets can range between 50, I think, and 100 bucks.
Right, exactly. And I'm also going to be doing a book signing there. So,
you
can pick up one of the books, too. So I truly believe that entrepreneurship is a great way for women to sort of even out the playing field.
Yeah, women helping women.
That's right, exactly.
There you go. Thank you. I appreciate your time
this
morning. All right. Oh, and Fox, too.